Hi guys, I'm Janaya.
And I'm Jake.
And this is Paul McCorgney.
From the Sergeant Pupper's Lonely Dogs Club Band.
And today we're gonna be making bake-a-bone treats for Paul to taste test.
So first of all, this is adorable. You've got these little doggy bones in here, the little molds that you just pour the food into. I like that part already, that's really fun.
I like that the fact that it makes four bones because it's not too much for your dog, but it's not too little, it's just the right amount. So I'm excited to try it out.
Paul can be a little bit of a picky eater, kind of a diva, as Paul McCorgney can be, but you know, I'm really excited to see how Paul handles this homemade treat baker, because I feel like he might like it. It'll have that homemade touch. With vegetables and carrots, that's not happening
for
Paul.
Not a fan.
Paul will walk away and never look back at that carrot.
Well, we'll see if that changes today.
Fingers crossed. Wait, Paul, it's coming. That's very Paul McCorgney. If you were Ringo, you would not be barking. Ringo would just be happy to be here.
Are you excited to taste it? Are you excited? Do you like it, Paul? I think he likes it.
Paul is digging it.
Oh, he loves it. You're gonna be eating carrots today. Ready, Paul? Here we go. Should I break it? What do you think?
Oh my god,
he's liking it.
Going for it. Paul's eating carrots.
He's eating
I told
carrots.
You.
Oh my.
Look at that smile.
Wow. Look at those happy ears. It was so easy to use, and there's so many different things that you can do with it. You can mix any ingredient in this, and it'll make a bone for your dog, which I love. So if your dog likes peanut butter, you can make a peanut butter treat. If your dog likes vegetables, you can make them a vegetable treat.
Paul really likes the treat.
He loves it.
He wants to let you know how he feels about it.